So this is it. May I introduce the wheel loader? It copies all major functions of a full-size wheel loader, and each function is driven electrically, even the steering. Children from 5 can drive it, as well as adults. The whole frame is mainly built from parts that come from the Dutch company Infento. They sell them in DIY building kits. With the included instructions, adults and kids can build a wide variety of vehicles, from toddler to teenager. Willkommen to today's video. My name is Jan. I'm an engineer living in Germany and I'm obsessed with creating Infento build rides since 2018. I got encouraged to present some of my creations here on the YouTube channel I named Modular Mobility. This wheel loader is not the largest ride in my lineup so far, but it has taken the leadership when it comes to complexity and functionality. I didn't come across using only standard parts. In this video, you will learn where and how I realized the required custom solutions. Now you better sit down. This journey is longer than it may appear at first sight. The shovel. No, there are no suitable shovels available on the potentially endless internet. Nothing from Rent a Digger nor from some rare caterpillar store. I had to build something by myself from scratch. 3D printing the shovel from plastic was no option because this part was way too big and would come out too fragile. I also didn't dare to go for plywood for reasons of stability and wall thickness. So I headed for a welded sheet steel solution. The basic layout is somehow an offspring of typical Lego shovels. I went for a width of 720 mm, which complies to the Infento 40 mm pattern. I had to keep an eye on the weight, which was easy as I used the 3D CAD system for designing. By using 2 mm sheet steel, I came out at a reasonable weight of only 10 kg. At the scrape edge, I stacked 2 sheets to improve the stiffness. At the top side, the stiffness was achieved by a V-shaped bending profile. In total, the shovel was made of 4 laser cut parts, from which 2 also needed to get bent. To get the shovel made, I was lucky in finding the sponsor of today's video, Schlosserei Jung in Schwanfeld. I really wonder if you will ever come to this sleepy village, but let me assure you that Schlosserei Jung is a perfect example of the typical German craftsmanship virtues: diligence, meticulousness and passion. I got welcomed by a smart and talented guy called Enrico. He had laser cut the 4 steel sheet pieces prior to my visit, but here you can see this fascinating process happening on another part. With the laser cut parts, we went to the bending machine, where Enrico evaluated the best order of the individual bending steps. Bending of any small radius was quite easy, but the large radius of the shovel was kind of a problem. We had no mating tool to bend it at once. The solution was to bend it very slightly every 15 mm, so the large radius became a kind of a polygon. From time to time, we could use well the side plates of the shovel as a template in order to create the best possible fit. After bending, we still had to bring the parts together by TIG welding. Enrico brushed all edges to clean them from remaining scale from laser cutting. A good weld preparation is an important prerequisite for a good result in TIG welding. First, the sheets were only lightly spot welded. Only when everything was in the right place, the seams were welded through. The order of welding was very important here to avoid distortion due to the heat effect. The welding took quite some time, but finally the result was even better than I expected. Respect. Well done, Enrico. When I arrived at home, I deburred all edges with a sand grinder and sharpened the scrape edge so it would get easier into the soil. Finally, to protect the shovel from oxidation, I gave it away for powder coating. Unfortunately, I cannot provide you with any video material at all, but as you can see here, the black glossy finish was the icing on the cake.